كتاب الله يهذبنا نعمل به كتاب أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم
أفغير الله أبتغي حكما وهو الذي أنزل إليكم الكتاب مفصلا والذين آتيناهم الكتاب يعلمون أنه منزل من ربك بالحق فلا تكونن من الممترين.
Should I seek a judge other than Allah when He is the one who has revealed this book with full details? Those whom we gave the book before you know very well that it is revealed to you from your Rabb with the truth. Therefore, you should not be of those who have doubts. Now, the context of the verse shows that it is about those people who have decided to walk on the path of Allah's deen, and they are criticized by the majority. The verse addresses such people and says that in a fit of tension, don't start proving to other people that no, this is an accusation on me and it is false. I have no such intention. I'm working with true sincerity. Now here these people are advised that you don't have to prove yourself to people. You do not owe an explanation to them. Your reaction should be that Allah knows my intentions. I have to prove myself only to Allah. If we implement this rule in our lives, that if anyone accuses us of anything which we have not done, we should not worry to prove ourselves right to people. Prove yourselves right to Allah alone, and He is the best of those who judge. Now the word Hakim and Hakama have a slightly different meaning. The word Hakim means the one who judges and makes right and wrong both kinds of decisions. And Hakama is the judge who makes only the right decisions. People can be Hakim, but Hakama is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This verse addresses to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but indirectly all of us are being taught this golden principle. This verse is a very important verse, especially for people like us who have just started to walk on the path of deen. You read the Quran, understand it, contemplate on it, you go home and decide to act on any command of Allah. People get after you, like you have put your hand in a bee's hive. People will tell you, no way, you're not doing it, this is wrong. Quran is telling you one thing and people are telling you another. And you get upset and confused what to do. And you start doubting what to do. Now this is the exact situation which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is dealing with right here. What will you do? The simple principle that is to be followed is that Allah will rule your life and not people. The sunnah and authentic ahadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will govern your life and no one else. And we should ask this question to ourselves and answer it once and for all, that will Allah dictate my life or people? And the end of the verse says, وَلَا تَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْمُمْتَرِينَ, that do not waste your life doubting. Follow the clear instructions of the Quran and the Sunnah with confidence and forget what anyone thinks or says about you.